Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It's my pleasure to welcome us to our Thursday weekly revival service in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Wherever you are listening to me in your various homes, I want you to bow your heads and let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus,
amen.
We magnify and we worship you because you are the one that has been our keeper. You are our help. You are the one who has preserved our life to be alive for such a time as this. We magnify you, Lord. We worship you. Today, O God, as we fellowship with you, let us experience your presence.
Amen.
Let us experience your power.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Wherever you are, I want you to stand up with me and worship God with me. We bless you, Lord. You are holy, holy Lord. And forever you are Lord. And forever you are Lord.
We bless you, Lord. You are
holy, holy Lord. And forever you are Lord. And forever you are Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You are Lord. Hallelujah. You are Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are Lord. I will call upon the Lord.
Call upon the Lord.
Who is worthy to be praised?
Who is worthy to be praised?
I will call upon the Lord.
We call upon the Lord.
Who is worthy to be praised?
Who is worthy to be
praised? So shall I be saved from my enemies. The Lord reigns. Blessed be the Lord. Let the rock of my salvation be exalted. The Lord reigns. Blessed be the Lord. Let the rock of my salvation be exalted. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you and have your seat. Please, I want you to pick your Bibles with me and open to the book of Daniel chapter 3. Daniel chapter 3, I'm going to read from verse 16 to verse 18. Then I will read from verse 21 to 25. The focus of our Thursday program in this month of April is benefits of serving God. We are going to look at divine benefits that children of God experience, which cannot be experienced if you are not a child of God. So Daniel chapter 3, I'm reading from verse 16 to verse 18. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered and said to the king, O Nebuchadnezzar, we are not careful to answer thee in this matter. If it be so, our God, whom we serve, is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us out of thy hand, O king. But if not, be it known unto thee, O king, that we will not serve thy gods, nor worship the golden image which thou hast set up. I will jump to verse 21 and read up to verse 25. Then these men were bound in their coats, their horses, and their hats, and their other garments, and were cast into the midst of the burning fiery furnace. Verse 22, therefore, because the king's commandment was urgent, and the furnace exceeding hot, the flame of the fire slew those men that took up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And these three men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, fell down bound into the midst of the burning fiery furnace. Then Nebuchadnezzar the king was astonished and rose up in haste and spake and said unto his counselors, did not we cast three men bound into the midst of the fire? They answered and said unto the king, true, O king. He answered and said, lo, I see four men loose walking in the midst of the fire, and they have no hurt, and the form of the fourth is like the Son of God. I'm speaking on what I call divine intervention. Divine intervention. We are living in a world of multiple darkness and wickedness. Today, we are hearing of new unbelievable dimension of evil and wickedness in our society. We are hearing of wicked killers, ritual killers, kidnappers, terrorists, wicked robbers, pleasure killers. These evils are being multiplied daily in our society. There are evidences that we are in the last days. Indeed, events that are happening today, they are following the prophecies of 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 1, that says, "This know that in the last days, perilous times shall come." Let me also say that evils are being multiplied in our world, almost in all societies, in various countries, and that's why the whole world is in perplexity at this time. I know within the past few weeks, or getting to about 2 months now, the whole world has been under the attack of coronavirus, something that nobody imagined could happen. Some days ago, I went to God and I said, "God, what was happening? Let me share with you what God told me about this coronavirus." God told me, "My child, coronavirus came as a result of man's wickedness to man. They developed it to destroy certain people, and Satan hijacked it from them to destroy the world." God now says, "I will cause solution to manifest." So solution is going to manifest over this issue of coronavirus plague. God says, "My children are preserved." But nations fighting God, nations fighting me, shall suffer long from it.
Amen.
God says, "It shall not depart completely. It will be a weapon against the wicked." Beloved, that is the word of God that I received. And that's why, for such a time as this, things that are happening, they are not ordinary. Revelation chapter 12, verse 12 says, "Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and the sea, for the devil is come down to you, having great wrath, because he knoweth that he hath but a short time." Today, I've come with a good news to you. If you're a child of God, the wrath of the devil is not for you. If you're a child of God, by the power of God, you will be preserved from the plague of this particular time. Beloved, Colossians chapter 3, verse 3 says, "Your life is hid with Christ in God." So by the power of God, you are not available for coronavirus. By the power of God, God shall intervene over your life.
Amen.
One of the ways by which God makes his children unavailable for plagues, for problems, as we are in the world, is through divine intervention. What is divine intervention? What is divine intervention? Divine intervention means for God to step into your matter and give you a supernatural solution. Beloved, for God to step into your matter and give you a supernatural solution. What again is divine intervention? Divine intervention is that it is the interference of God in human life. Somebody is here today by the power of God. Somebody is listening to me at this particular time. By the power of God, God will intervene in the affairs of your life.
Amen.
I prophesy into your own life, your time has come.
Amen.
I prophesy upon your life, God will intervene in the affairs of your life.
Amen.
If you look at that passage that we read at the beginning of this message, Daniel chapter 3, verses 16 to 18 and 21 to 25, you will see the case of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. They had been arrested. They were facing the test of their faith, either to serve God or to serve an idol, either to bow to God only or to bow to the idol of the king. These three boys were at a difficult time in their destiny. Their enemies thought that they were finished. the enemies thought that they have concluded over their lives. The king Nebuchadnezzar was full of fury against them. In fact, he commanded that they should hit the foreigners several times more than ever before. He asked that mighty men be chosen to handle their case. So their case was a special national punishment. They bound them. Probably you are listening to me at this time. You are bound by the enemies. Probably you are listening to me at this time. They concluded over your matter. Probably you are listening to me at this time. It looks as if there is no way for you. People who are supposed to be your friends, they are mocking you. They are standing by to say that your end has come. Beloved, that was the situation that Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego found themselves. They were thrown into that furnace. But something happened. The flame was so hot that it slew those who threw them into the fire. I pray today, anybody that want to throw you into a fire of wickedness, let the flame of God judge them.
Amen.
Let the flame of God judge them.
Amen.
Let the flame of God judge them.
Amen.
That was not the only thing that happened. So the king Nebuchadnezzar saw his own men dying before him, and he could not understand. The second thing that happened was that the king looked at the fire. He knew he threw there three men, but one way or the other, four men were standing. Fire had no power over them. A fourth person that he never invited, that he never threw into the fire, had intervened into the matter of the three Hebrew children. What happened to those three Hebrew children is what is called divine intervention. Beloved, are you in a difficult situation at this time? Are you struggling between life and death? Are you facing threats to your destiny? Is your life being mocked by the enemies? I've come to bring to you today the message of God, that God is ready to intervene in the affairs of your life. I heard the story of three witches who decided that in the night they were going to attack one woman. They carried a concoction of sickness in a bowl, and the three of them were going. They, unfortunately for them, to get to the house of the woman, they had to pass through a church. Strangely, that day, one woman who was not so educated was leading the prayer in that church at that time. And while the witches were going on, the strange prayer leader raised a prayer and said, every evil movement of satanic agent in the environment of this church be electrocuted by fire. Suddenly, beloved, when that prayer was raised, the witch that was carrying the concussion got electrocuted and threw the pot to the person in front. And the sickness that they planned for that man was thrown upon themselves. The person at the back was the one who ran back to tell them what happened. I pray for you today that God will intervene for you.
Amen.
I had a story of a village where there was no beer parlor, no cigarette selling center. But one way or the other, somebody just rose up. Some people just rose up and they started to sell cigarettes. They started to sell beer. And the church rose up. And the church started praying and say, oh God, intervene on our behalf. Get rid of these places where they are selling beer. Get rid of these places where they are selling cigarettes. Beloved, one day they just woke up to find that fire had raised the beer palace. And you know what happened after that? The beer parlor owners gathered together and they took the church to the court, saying that the court was responsible for the fire in their beer palace. And by the time they got to the court, they asked the church, are you responsible? They said, no, And they asked the Bible people, what's the song? They said, it was the prayer of these people. Then the church made a statement. He said, do you know the difference between the two of you? These people standing here, they know the power of prayer. You church, you are the one praying. You don't know that when you pray, your God intervenes on your behalf. I pray for you. You will recognize the power of prayer. As you are praying, as you are listening to me now, you will not doubt the power of the prayer you are praying. Please, as children of God, anytime we call upon our God, don't think that we are calling upon a God that does not understand or cannot hear. Whatever you ask, He has said, when you ask for anything in the name of Jesus, He will do it for you. Beloved, what happens when God intervenes in the affairs of man? What happens when God intervenes to the when His own children call upon Him? I want you to open your Bibles with me to Psalm 68. Psalm 68, I'm going to read verse 1. Psalm 68, I'm reading verse 1. It says, let God arise, let His enemies be scattered, let them also that hate Him flee before Him. Beloved, when God intervenes on your behalf, your enemies will scatter. Amen. When you call upon God to intervene on your behalf, your enemies will scatter. Amen. So as you are saying amen now, all the enemies that have conspired against your life, I command God to intervene and let them scatter now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Beloved, number two, when God intervenes in your matter, let me tell you, you will experience deliverance from the powers of your enemies. Daniel chapter 3, verse 25, he answered and said, no, I see four men loose, walking in the midst of the fire, and they have no hurt. That was an evidence of divine intervention. Beloved, when God intervenes in the affairs of your life, the power of the enemies will have no power over you. People will know that God is with your life. I pray for you. Please, such a time as we are in now is a time when you should know that you are not alone. Beloved, we are in a world now where God has released His angels to follow His children wherever they go. Child of God, there are some angels that are on an assignment on your behalf. When God intervenes in the affairs of your life, you will know that you are not alone. There are some heavenly guard angels who are guarding your life. I pray for you again. You will believe God as I'm telling you. Let God arise. Let God intervene in the affairs of your life.
Amen.
Number three thing that will happen to you when God intervenes in the affairs of your life is that restoration will take place for you. Restoration will take place for you. Whatever the enemies have taken away from your life, by the power of God, they shall restore. Somebody is listening to me at this time. Joel chapter 2, verse 25 will happen to you as you are saying amen now. See what that passage of the Bible says. It says, and I will restore to you the years that the locust had eaten, and the canker worm, and the caterpillar, and the palmer worms, my great army, which I sent among you. I want to pray for you. As you are praying now, let divine intervention take place.
Amen.
Whatever you have lost to the enemy, let them be restored back to you now.
Amen.
Number four thing that happens when God intervenes for you is that you will experience healing. In Matthew chapter 8, verses 14 to 15, Jesus followed Peter home, saw Peter's mother laid sick of fever. He touched her hand and the fever left. Beloved, that sick woman rose up because God intervenes in the affairs of her life. Anybody, anywhere now that is sick, that is lying down, I speak to you. receive the power in the blood of Jesus and be healed in the mighty name of Jesus. Any child of God that has been said to be afflicted or inflicted with coronavirus, right now, hear the word of the Lord. God has come to intervene for you wherever you are. Rise up and be healed.
Amen.
Rise up and be healed.
Amen.
Rise up and be healed.
Amen.
Receive your healing now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Receive your healing now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Beloved, when God intervenes in the affairs of your life, your prayer requests will become testimonies. Those requests you are making, they will become testimonies in your life. I want you to know that this message is not an ordinary message. This message is coming at a time when many people are down. This message is coming at a time when there's lockdown. This message is coming at a time when people are asking, can God do something? I've come to bring you hope that God is available to intervene in the challenges that is facing the world. Doctors have told them that, have told us that they have solution. I've come to tell you that there's a solution in our God. I pray today this world will see divine intervention.
Amen.
This world will not pass through this coronavirus plague without knowing that there is a God in heaven who, when the children of God call upon, he intervenes upon on their behalf. I pity those who are happy that churches are closed down. The solution to this coronavirus is in the prayer of the beloved. The solution to this coronavirus is in the prayer of children of God who are calling upon God for his own intervention. Beloved, when God intervenes in the affairs of this world, there will be miracles. And I'm praying that this miracle will manifest.
Amen.
People have been saying, coronavirus will not go. Coronavirus will take so long a time. But beloved, there are nations that this coronavirus cannot reach. The nations where the children of God rise up to say, no, our land is surrounded by the blood of Jesus. And that is why, children of God, you cannot afford to keep quiet. At this period of coronavirus, children of God, this is the time to call upon our God. This is the time to show this world the power of our God. And that's why I've come today. Let God arise. Let God intervene in the challenges that is facing the world right now. You coronavirus, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You coronavirus, I command in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because of the prayers of the children of God in this nation, leave Nigeria alone.
Amen.
Lose your hold over Nigeria.
Amen.
What you did to them in Spain, what you did to them in Italy, I forbid you from doing it to us in Nigeria.
Amen.
What you've done to them in France, by the power of God, you will fail over Nigeria.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Why? We are calling upon our God to intervene. We are a nation. We are big. People talk of wickedness in Nigeria, but thank God, this same country, Nigeria, is a country where there are many children of God. And people, it's time for you to see the power of our God that can intervene, our God that can create a caution and say, as this coronavirus has come to this land, for the hopes of children of God, I pray right now, let it become the Goshen of our time.
Amen.
Let the homes of children of God be Goshens of our time.
Amen.
Everywhere you are, where you are saying amen, I'm asking God to intervene in your family.
Amen.
Let your family become a Goshen.
Amen.
The plague that is killing people in the world, let your home be shielded from that plague in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let coronavirus have no portion in your home. Receive divine immunity in your family in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let all your children, wherever they are, let them be protected. Let them be protected.
Amen.
Let there be divine intervention over your life.
Amen.
Beloved, this is not the first time that God will be intervening in the challenges of people. This is not the first time that God will be intervening when his own children call upon him. Let me share with you some cases of divine intervention in the Bible. The first one that comes to my mind now is the intervention of God in the battles that was confronting the children of Israel. If you look at Joshua chapter 10 verse 12 God made the sun to stand still to enable Joshua to accomplish his purpose. That was a divine intervention. I pray today that all the enemies that operate in the midnight, that choose darkness to attack your life, I pray that the God that stopped the sun so that they can be destroyed by Joshua's army, let that sun remain, so that your enemy will have no darkness to hide in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Beloved, in Daniel chapter 6, verse 22, God sent his own angel to shut the mouth of the lion because of Daniel. That was divine intervention. Daniel 6, verse 22, Daniel testified, he said, my God has sent his angel to shut the mouth of the lion. Are you listening to me at this time? Have you been thrown into the lion's den? Beloved, there is a God who can send his angel to your life. That place where you are located right now, please, I want you to receive angelic intervention. Receive angelic intervention in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Are you sick? Express angelic intervention. Let there be sudden miracle over your situation in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray for sudden healing in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for divine intervention in the name of Jesus. Have they planned to use book, paper, to write a letter to destroy you? That power, those satanic agents conspiring to write a petition against you, let them be paralyzed in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Beloved, you know the story of how the children of Israel left Egypt. And after they left Egypt, Pharaoh now woke up and decided to pursue them. Beloved, Pharaoh was so swift with horses and with his army, and he would have caught up with the children of Israel. But for what happened in Exodus chapter 14, from verse 24 to 25, we are told God slowed down the Egyptians so that the children of Israel could go across the sea. Right now, the progress of your enemy will be slowed down.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus,
amen.
God will intervene on your behalf. Are you listening to me at this time? You are saying, my own problem is not all this thing we are talking of. All I just want God to do is for God to give me something that I lack in my life. That was the story of Hannah. 1 Samuel chapter 1. The other wife was making jest of Hannah because she had no child, but God intervened for her. Are you in need at this particular time? I want you to know that God still answers prayers. The God that intervened for Hannah, that same God will intervene for your life. I pray for you today. God will intervene for you. God will intervene for you. God will intervene for you in the name of Jesus. Let me share with you some facts about God's intervention so that you will know that what I'm telling you today is based on the word of God. Open with me, please, to the book of Isaiah chapter 43. Isaiah chapter 43, I'm going to read verses 2 and 3. Isaiah 43, I'm reading verses 2 and 3. It says, when thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burnt, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. For I am the Lord thy God, the only one of Israel, thy Savior. I gave Egypt for thy ransom, Ethiopia and Seba for thee. Beloved, what God did in this passage, many years for the children of Israel, God is doing that for you too. Are you passing through the waters right now? God says he will intervene. He will be with you.
Amen.
Are you going through the rivers right now? God says, I should tell you, that water will not overflow you.
Amen.
Because God will be with you.
Amen.
Are you going through the fire of life? By the power of God, you shall not be burnt. Are you listening to me at this time? Some people, some forces are asking you, commit suicide. End it all. Nobody is for you. Nobody loves you. Please, I want you not to listen to them, because I want you to know that God loves you. By the power of God, anybody that's about to commit suicide now, let there be divine intervention. Let there be divine intervention.
Amen.
Let there be divine intervention.
Amen.
Beloved, look at the book of Psalm 91. As I read from verses 14 and 15, it says, because he has set his love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high, because he has known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. Are you in trouble right now? There is a God that has promised to intervene for you. He has promised to deliver you. He has promised to honor you. Right now, beloved, I want you to receive the divine intervention of God upon your life. I want you to experience the power of God that intervenes on behalf of those who call upon him. Why not seize this opportunity? Don't give up, beloved. Don't give up, beloved. There is still hope for you, because there is a God that intervenes on behalf of his own children. This same God says in Jeremiah chapter 33, verse 3. Jeremiah 33, verse 6 says, call unto me, and I will answer thee, and show thee great and mighty things which thou knowest not. Beloved, God is sending this message through me to you. God is saying, call unto him. Please, at this particular time, I want you to get ready to call unto God, because God will intervene in the affairs of your life. Do you know what God has told us? Matthew chapter 7, verses 7 and 8. He says, ask and it shall be given to you. That was Jesus Christ telling us this. He said, seek and ye shall find. He said, knock and shall be opened to you. For everyone that asketh, receiveth. And he that seeketh, findeth. And to him that knocketh, it shall be opened. Beloved, in what areas of your life do you want divine intervention? What are the things happening to you now for which you want God to intervene for you? I want to plead with you. Please, call upon God. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 15 is for you. It says, for all things are for your sake, that the abundant grace might through the task of many rebound to the glory of God. Beloved, divine intervention is available for you. Divine intervention is available for you. One of the reasons why God wants to intervene in your situation is because it is when God intervenes in the affairs of his people that God is glorified in their lives. Please, God is not glorified when you are defeated. God is not glorified when your enemies put you to shame. That's why I'm very convinced today that as we call upon God, God will intervene for you. Please, you are going to rejoice. Please, you are going to praise God again. You are still going to thank God. Divine intervention is for you. God has made available divine intervention to stop the progress of the enemy, to put to shame the enemies of your life. I want you to know that our God will intervene for you. Please, before I end up this message today, I want you to look at your own situation to know if you really want divine intervention. Are you listening to me right now and you don't want the forces of darkness to destroy you? Please, call for divine intervention. Are you listening to this message right now and there are some stubborn forces that are oppressing your life? Please, you can overcome them by asking God for divine intervention. Are you listening to me now and the situation of your life is that there are some evil conspiracies around you? Beloved, cry unto God for divine intervention and you experience the power of God. Are you like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego? Enemies thought that they've concluded your case. They've done it already. But let me tell you, even in that situation, God can deliver you. Are you here today? People are asking, can miracles happen in your life? I have a good news for you. Miracles can still happen in your life. There's a God that is ready to intervene on your behalf. In concluding this message today, what should you do for divine intervention to take place in your life? What should you do so that you too can experience the divine intervention of God Almighty? Number one, make yourself to become a child of God by surrendering your life unto Jesus Christ. Become a child of God. One of the purposes why this message is coming up is to challenge you and let you know that you cannot live your life without God. Beloved, you need to take a decision about God. You cannot say that you are a free thinker. You don't belong to God and don't belong to the devil. You surely belong to one. If you are not for God, you are for the devil. If you are not living for God, I know that your spirit tells you if you are not living for God. So look at your life. Are you for God or for the devil? Number two thing that you should do is to activate your faith in God. Activate your faith in God by calling upon God today. Beloved, God is available to answer your prayers. If you will call upon Him, He will intervene for you. And that's why I will help you to call upon Him. But before we call upon Him today, wherever you are, I want you to bow your heads and you will pray like this. Say, "Oh God, my Father, I've come to reconnect back to you. Have mercy upon me. Jesus, I know I need you. I know that without you, I am nobody. Today, I surrender the whole of my life unto you. Jesus, have the whole of me. Everything that concerns me, I allow you free access to it. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen." Beloved, if you have prayed that prayer with me from the depth of your heart, I know that you can now pray along with me. The first prayer that I want you to pray with me is this. You will say, "Oh God, my Father, as I call upon you now, intervene on my behalf in the name of Jesus. Oh God, my Father, as I call upon you now, intervene in the affairs of my life in the name of Jesus. Oh God, my Father, as I call upon you now, intervene in the affairs of my life in the name of Jesus. Oh God, my Father, as I call upon you now, intervene in the affairs of my life in the name of Jesus. Amen." The second prayer I want to pray, say, "Oh God, my Father, as I call upon you now, deliver me from the powers of my enemies in the name of Jesus. Oh God, my Father, as I call upon you now, deliver me from the powers of my enemies in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, my Father, as I call upon you now, deliver me from the powers of my enemies in the name of Jesus. Amen." Are you listening to me now? Probably the enemies thought they've concluded you. Please pray this next prayer. Say, "Whatever the enemies have done in my life, as I pray now, be reversed in the name of Jesus. Whatever the enemies have done in my life, as I pray now, be reversed in the name of Jesus. Be reversed in the name of Jesus. Whatever the enemies have done in my life, as I pray now, be reversed in the name of Jesus." Amen. Probably you are listening to me right now. You have been feeling sad for some days. I want you to know that God can intervene for you. You will pray like this. "Anything that is making my heart to be sad, as I pray now, lose your powers over me in the name of Jesus. Anything that is making my heart to be sad, as I pray now, lose your powers over me in the name of Jesus. Anything that is making my heart to be sad, as I pray now, Lose your past over me. Lose your past over me in the name of Jesus. Beloved, as you are listening to me, you need divine intervention. For some people, for that divine intervention to take place, God will send some human helpers to your life. That's why I want to pray for your helpers. Say, oh God, my Father, wherever my helpers are right now, let them appear and start to help me. In the name of Jesus, oh God, my Father, wherever my helpers are right now, let them appear and start to help me. In the name of Jesus, oh God, my Father, wherever my helpers are right now, let them appear and start to help me. In the name of Jesus, amen. Daddy, as you are listening to me now, you are in the midst of kidnappers. Or you are listening to me now, they've already thrown you into the lion's den. Beloved, God can send his angel. God can put your kidnappers to sleep. God can send his angel. God can let them hear a noise that is divert their attention. I pray for anybody under the captivity of the enemy right now. Let there be a noise that will make your captors to run away. In the name of Jesus, let God intervene. Anybody that's in any captivity right now, I pray in the name of Jesus, let a way of escape open for you. I ask, oh Lord, let the angels of God come on assignment to deliver your life in the name of Jesus. By the power of God, God is intervening in your affairs. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Before we share the grace today, beloved, I want you to know that by the grace of God, on Sunday, by 8 o'clock in the morning, I want you to get ready in your home. We shall be having service, church in your home. Your home is a church. You will gather together with all your family and connect to the same channel, and we shall have a church together. I mean, dress yourself up, because you are going to a church in your home. Sit down in your sitting room and get ready to meet with God. God bless you. The God that has spoken to you today, that God will never leave your home alone. Your house is becoming a special house. That house where you are is an altar. Get ready to experience the power of God. God bless you. Let us share the grace of God together. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us for now and forevermore, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. And I prophesy into your life, this coronavirus shall not know your house.
Amen.
You are preserved.
Amen.
You are protected.
Amen.
Everywhere you go, experience divine immunity.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.
Amen.
Let's give God 3 thanksgiving. Hallelujah. Let's go. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Amen. God bless you.